Hello, this is Vern, and on today's episode, I'm going to be sharing with you how to know if a man is wasting your time and what you can do about it starting today. Stick with me. Hello, this is Vern. Welcome to your great lifetv.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, successful, heart-centered women how you can create the relationship of your dreams with no gimmicks, manipulation, or crazy techniques, but as a result of stepping into the most alive and the most feminine version of yourself. I hear this question very, very often when I connect with women from all over the world, and that question is, I think this guy's wasting my time, or I'm not sure how to know if the guy's wasting my time. So let me start with a principle. I know it seems like a play on words, but it really makes sense if you think about it, based on you feeling empowered versus feeling like a victim. And that is the concept of nobody wastes your time. You waste your time when you spend time with someone who's not good for you, or with someone who's not compatible with you, or when you far extend the length of a spiritual contract with someone. The second thing I want to say is that my definition of time wasting is the probability of you getting what you want through doing what you're doing is either very low or it's just not gonna happen. It's null, right? Why? Because if you are going to a specific destination and the actions you're taking are taking you to an opposite destination, that's when I consider this time wasting. Now, there's two concepts that I want to get clear right now. The first one is, I'm gonna hear from some people who say, well, ultimately, everything is a lesson and everything happens for a reason, so it's not really wasting of time because you're going through a path and a spiritual journey. And I get it, trust me. Here's when I have a problem and a biff with that theory. I have a problem with that theory when the problem you're facing right now with this man is the same fucking problem you faced with the previous guy and the previous guy and the previous guy. Then it's not really a lesson that you're learning, it's a lesson you're not learning and a lesson you're not moving forward from. And then you're really stuck in kindergarten of lessons instead of graduating to the next level problem that will allow you more possibilities in life. I'm not going for you not having any problems. I'm just going for you having better quality problems that allow you to have a more fulfilling life. So if the probability of you getting what you want is not going to happen, it's low or it doesn't exist, by definition, you're wasting your time. So here's three steps that I feel are going to help you to overcome the question, is he wasting my time? And more than just the question, allow you to step into the kind of relationship that you really want. The first question you need to figure out is, you need to find out what his intentions are and listen to him when he says what his intentions are. So here's what I mean. You need to be courageous enough, playful enough, and tactful enough to ask that question without it seeming like an inquisition, but at the same time, without avoiding asking the question. Here's why, because if his intentions are, he just came out of a relationship, and he's not really into doing something long-term, he doesn't want a life partner, he definitely doesn't want family, and you are looking for a lifelong companion and family, then that's a mismatch. If you don't talk about it, here's what's gonna happen. You're gonna start creating connection with him, you're gonna feel closer to him, you're gonna feel more attachment, and then lo and behold, month number four, he reveals the question he could have answered the first meeting, which is, I'm not looking for something serious. And at that point, you feel devastated because you've given your heart and soul, open yourself up in ways that you haven't in years, and then your heart is crushed. So I'm asking you right now to have the courage to ask good questions in terms of what his intent, not his intentions with you, his intentions in general. So in essence, you're figuring out in the best of scenarios, if he hits the jackpot of relationships, what is the jackpot of relationships to him right now? That's the first part of the equation. Second part of the equation, and it requires, again, tact to be able to figure out this, is what's the ideal for him in terms of time frame? Here's why, because the idea might be the same in terms of what he wants, but he might be in a 5-year plan and you might be in a 1-year plan, and that's still a mismatch, right? So you want to be courageous in asking good questions early and often and make sure that you're both in the same freaking planet and not going to different galaxies, right? Second part is listening to him, because here's the truth. Sweetheart, sometimes he'll tell you, I'm looking for something low-key right now. I'm not looking for commitment. And what you hear is, today I don't want commitment, but tomorrow maybe I do. And if you extrapolate that answer and you add from your own once and you turn it into something that it's not, then again, you're going to end up wasting your time. By definition, wasting your time would be that he wants something and he's making it clear to you that he wants something easy, low-key, and that you interpret it to mean that maybe a month from now he wants something serious. Don't do that. Don't waste your time doing that. Second thing that you need to understand is you need to be able to gauge the capacity that he has in action, big, bold explosion, in action and through time. Those are two important factors. One, in action means that his words, his poetry, his Rumi inside of him actually has 2 feet that can stand on the ground and walk the talk that he's talking. And how do you gauge this? You gauge this through his pursuit. Is he really pursuing you? Is he really planning for the future? Is he wanting more than just something that starts? Imagine that you start connecting with him once a week and texting a couple times a week. 2 months later, he's doing the same thing. That's not in action telling you that he wants more. That's in action telling you, I'm very comfortable with this minimum level engagement in order to have what I want without a lot of investment on my part. Third one is, don't become exclusive with a man until you both are clear that the definition of what you want matches, that you've developed a friendship that's starting to become solid or is solid already, and that his actions are showing you that what he means is true. Then, is it still a risk? Absolutely still a risk, but it's a much lower risk than if you blind yourself with a blindfold and then jump in with both feet without really understanding what he means and just go based on his first strong, excited intentions, okay? And I'll close with this one thing. I'll close it by saying that throughout the entire process, you need to be very cognizant of red flags, but you also need to be cognizant of things that don't feel right in your heart that you can clarify. It doesn't mean that you end the relationship. It just means that you have a chance to voice what you want, clarify, and make sure that it's not something that's going to blow up or become a really big thing in the future. He's planting an acorn tree right now, and later on there's an oak that's gigantic, and you could have asked him about the acorn he's planting right now, right? but you didn't. So what I'll say to you is that the long-term damage of lying to yourself in small little ways throughout the time you're getting to know him is significantly, exponentially worse than the punch of honesty right now. I'll say it again. The long-term damage of lying to yourself is significantly worse than the punch of today, the honesty punch of today. That means that if you don't tell yourself the truth, you'll get the punch in the future, but you get the punch 3 years later. You get the punch after wasting 3 years of your life that will never come back. Hope this is helpful, useful, insightful, my dear. If it is, I'm gonna ask you to do 3 things. Thing number 1, click like on this video. Thing number 2, or thumbs up. Thing number 2, subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. And once you do, click the little bell so you get notified of new episodes as soon as they come out. 3rd thing, if you want to go deeper in this understanding, there's 2 things I have for you. The first one, on the first line of the description of this video, I'm going to be sharing with you a link that you can click on, enter your name and email, and go through a masterclass that goes with at more depth on these concepts that show you how to enter the relationship you want with less pain. If you say to me, Bern, I love the videos and I've binge watched a bunch of them, thank you so much, I still need more help. I want more hand-holding, specific help into creating this result that I have not been able to create for years and years, but it's the most important thing in my life right now, then there's another link in the description of this video that will allow you to apply for working with me. We'll have a conversation. If I feel I can help you, my assistant will reach out, we'll establish time to connect, and then we can start working. If it's not a fit, then we'll let you know as well. Thank you so much for connecting with me, and as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.